How are y'all doing this afternoon? My name is Matthew Wright, and I go by Matt, but I'm a spiritual teacher and leader and here in Richmond, and I'm also a psychic spirit medium and empathic intuitive. This is my friend and associate, Jeremy Elliott.
Jeremy Elliott, I'm also from Richmond, Virginia. I'm a spiritual teacher and leader and clairvoyant psychic and medium.
Good. And you might have, I don't know if you've had a chance to look over some of the other things we've done on this YouTube page, but we help people in this world, in our dimension here, who want to contact the spirit world, but we also help the spirit world contact people here. And this young man here, Drick or whatever.
We'll call him D.
We'll call him D, but, you know, but he wants to... Yeah, he's coming through. So, and sometimes I just want to let people know, like, I'm okay. Yes, sometimes it's that, or just sometimes it's other things. But what's up, D-Man?
He wanted you just, you know, talk about how you knew who he was.
Dude, Tony, yeah. You want me to talk about Tony and stuff, man?
Okay. Just how close by we lived.
Yeah. Like, yeah, well, look, like, I know you lived on, God, what's that name of the street? Well, it doesn't matter. Like, you know, we're just Drake with him, man. It's something like that. But, you know, when you're, like, right by Southgate. I know he lived over by Southgate, but my friend Tony lived a couple doors down from him. I was always over at Tony's house. So when I heard that that he died, like, I think Tony had mentioned it to me. I heard about it anyway. I knew that he lived right by Tony. So... You know, so that's how it kind of came to be, you know?
Yeah, he remembers seeing Tony, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Tony and Dre and Cecil, too. Remember Cecil? They were right down the street from Cecil and Dot. Right next to Southgate. So, but you probably seen me around before, drive by before, but I was over there enough, D. But go ahead, man, you know, but...
He's just talking. He's just
go ahead, talk, man. You know, want me to keep talking?
Yeah, he's cool. He's just hanging out. He's just saying, "I'm here." You know.
Yeah.
I can describe him a little bit.
Yeah, describe him, man. Go ahead and describe him.
He's got like braids in his hair, you know, like pulled back, you know, and then like a wife beater on, and some dark colored pants, you know, like jeans, you know, baggy with the white sneakers on, you know. He's like, that's me.
Like that. Tall and skinny.
Yeah, tall and skinny.
Oh, yeah. But, see, I think this will help you people, too. They come across this, too. You know, like, you have a lot of people are putting a lot of heavy grief load on you with their emotion or not. Not too bad.
Everybody is grieving over.
Everybody is.
Over me, you know.
I figured that. And I know it's weighing you down, man, so...
It's weighing me down, you know, but I have to keep on going. You know, I have to keep going.
Oh, yeah, man. Oh, yeah. Yeah,
you know. Because this is the life, you know. This is the life.
I know you're a lot happier that I feel that coming from you, man. You're a lot happier in the new existence than this all crappy world here, so...
But there wasn't nothing going on for me at the time anyway.
So it was kind of good. I mean, this is hard to hear right here, but he's kind of saying maybe it was good timing.
Yeah, I was just chilling. You know, I was chilling, and now I'm keeping on, you know.
Yeah. Like, at least you're well-adjusted, man, D. We come across a lot who aren't, so... But at least, you know, he's well... Let me speak to your people watching. Like, he's well-adjusted, you know. As hard as it is to hear, and I know you're sad and you're grieving over him and all of that, but... Please don't be. That's his, you know, that's one thing I think he'd like to have come through. Said he there's no need to be upset anymore. You know, like he's chilling. He's happy. You know, that's a happy, happy world where he is.
Yeah, he's happy.
It's just as real as this world. It isn't some airy place like with like clouds, and it can be if you want it to be, but it's just as real feeling as this. You know, dimension.
He said, "I know my grandma wouldn't want to hear this, but you can smoke all the blunts you want." It hasn't.
I like that, D, man. I was about to comment on that. Like, you know, there is no God like we might think of it in this dimension. Like, not like that. You know, the God's not censoring what people do. We've had gangbangers come through from L.A. and partying, slamming champagne toast together on the other side. Yeah, people sniffing coke. I've seen that.
Because of heaven there.
Because it's heaven. It is heaven to you. It is like heaven because it's whatever you want. You know?
Yeah, he's saying it's heaven. Like, we don't necessarily say that, you know.
We don't call it heaven because it's a lot open to misinterpretation.
Right, right. That's all it is.
I call it the other side. It's another dimension. It's one dimension of many.
It's more like if you eat a chocolate and that's heaven. You know, that's what he's saying. This is heaven. You know.
He's happy. Like, I like how he said, but I can't. That's funny, though, D. Like, your grandma wouldn't want to hear that. I can feel your grandma, too. But, yeah, you can smoke all at once. You can smoke all at once he wants. He can drink all the beer he wants or all the liquor he wants.
Get drunk and then get drunk again and again.
See, like, he's partying. Like, you know, maybe, like, y'all should party for him. I've given this advice to families we've helped. Like, it's good that maybe throw a party for him instead of...
When he saw the bullets coming, he won't prepare for that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's what he's saying to me. I didn't mean to cut you
no,
off.
No. Go ahead, dude.
When
he saw
the bullets coming, you know, he didn't... He was like this. You know, like, you know, not prepared.
Yeah, but that was your rote reaction. That's basic instinct to be like that. But
it took time, you know. It took him time to move on, you know. But when he did, he was happier than suffering. And suffering through all that, he was better. And then immediately knew that this was heaven.
Yeah.
You know.
That's good. Yeah. I remember the day you died, man, because I kind of sensed you. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, I was out in another part of town that I could kind of feel, like, you know, this was years ago, but I could feel the presence, you know. And, like, I was telling Jeremy about that earlier, I think, just driving by where it happened. I lived in San Susie for a long time, so right around the corner. But, but yeah, man, like, you know.
The Sues.
yep. You know, that's where I met Tony out over there, so, you know, back years ago. But anyway, though. But look, I want to say that's heaven. He's in, like, you know, this is heaven to him because he can have anything he wants. Like, think about it. Pop, there it is, whatever it is. You know, there's no money, no need to worry about some job that you're doing, the job you hate, trying to pay the rent. There's no God sitting there judging people. It's not
you're not sitting there worrying about the things that you worry about here, like, is, you know, are the dishes clean, are you clean, you know, you know how are my teeth, or... You know, or my shoes, what kind of clothes I got on. You know, you don't worry about that stuff, you know.
There's no judgment either. Like, no other people are really saying, oh, you're a shitty person, you know, like that. Yeah. You know, but you look nasty, you know, like, you're worthless. You're this or that, so you're not as good as me.
Your clothes aren't cool, you know, or something.
You just change your clothes thinking about it.
Yeah.
You know, no clothes at all, whatever.
Exactly. Yeah. That's a good point. Yeah, you just, whatever, you know. I've seen that happen many times in the spirit world, you know, just constant changing clothes, constant hats coming on and off. You see color, their skin changes, you know.
They're just playing with themselves, like seeing what they can do, you know?
Yeah, you know, going, their thoughts are quick, you know, like.
Instant manifestation.
Yeah, that's But anyway, I guess we got off subject.
No, it's all right. It all relates to this brother here. Yeah, you know?
He said y'all are interesting people, man. He said motherfuckers, you know.
Hey, man, like, this is what we do, man. In this world, you know, we don't. Look, D, you know, you see, we don't let the world tell us what we can do, you know? We don't conform. I ain't never conformed, my brother, you know?
No.
I don't believe in conforming. Like, society says, like, well, Matt, you need to go out and get some job and just try to get by. You need to do what society tells you to do. F that.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?